Ron here lives right around the corner.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I just over on 3rd Street.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, there used to be another guy had a garden layout just down on Mardell here kind of thing, so when the two of us were open all the time, people would like use this as their starting point, and ding, ding, and they'd hit us off pretty quick. So I used to really, when they first started, it was like every morning they'd be
an early day,
and they'd be lining up, and then there'd be this like 3-hour window in the middle.
Yep.
And not a soul would show up, and then in the middle of the afternoon, everyone would start showing up again about between 2 and 5.
So this morning it wasn't too bad, or?
No, it was just, it's been very, very well spaced out all day long. So
beautiful day for it.
Yeah, so people are coming and they can stay for as long as they want. Because you get 15 people and they all show up at the same time. Oh, and, well, and only then somebody really feels uncomfortable, so they're like, oh, okay, I'm going to go eat.
Yeah.
Well spaced, so people can all stay as long as they want.
So you're saying that these are the original buildings over here?
Yep, those are all some of those. These are all the last things they built over this.
That brown one looks really nice.
Yeah, that's
the tan one. Yeah. Yeah.
This was one of the original things too, actually. This open air loading dock kind of thing. That was one of the original ones I had made too. That was just scratch built. I'm just seeing something. I need something small to. Well, actually, I had the loading ramp. I had the loading ramp somewhere, and then I was looking at it, going, this thing needs something else. There got to be something else I can do with this thing, so that's small and not too cumbersome.
Yeah, yeah.
So then I just put a roof on half of it. And then a friend of mine copied it, and he made one just like it.
That's the sign of a good idea.
Yeah.
The second someone steals it, it's a good idea.
Those Quonset houses are the perfect houses to put on the edge so you can lean over and you don't catch your sleeve on all the corners. Those nice round behind you there.
Boy. Oh, goodness.
I first had a building there, just leave them there to try them out.
Better than putting your signals there, eh, Ron?
You keep banging on them and leaning on them. And
yeah, mister, break my signals when it was over.
I tore one off this layout the other day. That's a good point.
And they're round, nothing catches on them.
Yeah. Yeah, I just made one the other day, or about a month ago.
So that's the perfect place.
I don't know if you know much about machine shops, but there's milling machines and lathes and drill presses and.
You see the flickering light? But yeah. Is it?
No, there's no flickering light in there.
The light flickers a little tiny bit.
Just a little tiny bit. Yeah, if you want to go around, get a good shot around that.
When they start to lathe, that the light flickers.
It looks great. It flickers because it's from the bar flashing sign.
Oh, okay.
This is a refinery. Vivian made all this refinery from here to here. Handmade it all.
Chris, you realize you're just going to go on my YouTube channel.
Right? Well, which isn't. I better not swear then.
Yeah, sometimes you like.
It's okay. I'll bleep it out.
My channel.
It's okay. New channel, yeah.
Thanks.
Right.
I'm
going to
get too smug here.
Look at this.
Yeah, isn't that nice? Looks great.
It's all scratch built.
All scratch built. Yeah. From here down, like from there down, scratch. You can buy the.
Yeah. Okay.
From there down, that's all handmade.
That's the best looking part over here. Anyways, right.
Well, that big tank was amazing. That huge tank. Well, the curb handrail and the curb stairs, she hand built all that.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Out of styrene.
So, yeah. Just out of styrene sheet. Yeah. And those are just little bits of pipe, individual piece of pipe, and then she added all the features to it just to make
wonderful.
It
wonderful. No, I don't have near enough.
The color is great.
Yeah.
But you
I'm trying to go in this direction. No, I'm trying to. That's why I'm so slow, because I don't want to just, oh, forget it, it's close enough. I want it to look the way I want it to look.
But right now you've got kind of like Arizona desert scene.
Yeah.
No trees.
No, I need like 8 million trees.
Yeah,
you know, I have to get you guys out.
Yeah.
As I said, I've been volunteering at the school twice a week, so And then I just got done hockey.
Cantonary.
Yeah.
And then Monday night is an operating session.
I was supposed to do this on the repeater.
And then there's some other things on the go, you know, and it's just...
I ended up...
If you go back to work,
I gave in.
You would be surprised.
Your mom had a white car. She says, you always have your car. I'm tired of not being able to go.
Yeah, that little bar there, she made that sign, the little flashing sign. And the bar all lights up inside. Different colors.
Wonderful.
It's all furnished in there. Is it over here? It's a little appliance store. She made all the appliances for inside the store, the fridge and stove.
Can't be ordering because I didn't touch anything in that regard.
And then down here is a little music shop. The guitar and the French horn. That French horn's actually brass, and she made that on her lathe.
Oh, really?
I finally got it running again.
There's a little guitar and there's a little instrument.
I sent the decoder away to have it upgraded from a version 3 to a 4. You sent me back to
the room. You can really tell when the hobby captures somebody's mind, right?
Well, I said
it wasn't behaving.
Is this Thorndale you're talking about?
Sorry?
Thorndale?
Yeah, Nick and I were both members of
Tense Valley. Do you sand off or do you take the varnish off the brass?
You know, I didn't in the Hudson and I maybe should have put it in some... some lacquer thinners. They're not going to do the solder.
The lacquer thinners is really.
No, but it's solid. It's all brass and solid.
Oh, it's brass.
Yeah, it's brass. Yeah.
No plastic on it whatsoever.
No
plastic on
it. No, but all the plastic comes off anyways. So when you just
look inside. Yeah, like your little brick.
She makes her own. Yeah, she made that too. She made the little tanks in the background. Yeah. She made all that by hand. Yeah.
You say you can sand
and then this is the vineyard. This is the vineyard.
Oh, yeah. Very fine. Because I did have some problems when I was taking the tape off. Done with it. With an airbrush, I had more of the paint, and of course, it
and then there's a stretcher over there that brings you up to this line. That takes you over to the coal. Then you cross this bridge,
150?
Then you go through this mountain.
But there's a little,
then you go down this track here, and then it splits here, and it goes down in behind the refinery. There's a track, and it goes down, and then it comes out in this tunnel. So you can have a complete loop going from upper to lower.
I really like the retaining wall. It fits so well. Like, a lot of people really don't figure out how they can get that transition.
And these things lift out, these sections that lift out. So what we did with these two trees here, the ones you grab onto and you can lift the whole unit.
Yeah, I do that too.
You can lift it up. So that lifts out. And then this section here lifts out. This section here lifts out.
I build all my models with a super stable point to grab, like usually a chimney or something.
Yeah.
You grab it by that chimney, you can grab it anywhere, it won't break. Grab it anywhere else, it will be destroyed.
It's from 20 years.
And all these buildings here, these are all photographs of downtown London.
I've noticed that.
Yeah, the downtown London. So we just like
video.
And the darn thing, you know, you have the acrylic. I was just trying to paint some the overhead crane in there. That's all I was trying to paint. So I give the light coat because you can't give a very heavy otherwise
here. So where's this club? Where is the club in Thorndale?
I wait for a little while. I go spray
the fairgrounds.
Another coat and finish
with
the
fairgrounds.
Oh, it's at the fairgrounds.
That never used to happen.
Have our own building.
Was it always there?
Oh, it's always there for quite a while.
Yeah, in the animals.
Now it's fixed. It was only a module and now it's fixed. And so now we can put bigger buildings on that.
No, the one inside the building.
Inside the building.
You have to go back in there?
I strive to be able to picture that. You know, like when you do the little machines and stuff like that, you really have to envision that when you pick up your little pieces.
Most of the time I pick them up with the tip of the X-Acto knife. And sometimes you can pick them up, but I don't know if you noticed inside the building on top of the table there is a welding mask.
That's incredible.
The welding mask. You couldn't pick it up with anything. I could only move it. I had to just manage to do things by just moving it around without ever picking it
the
up.
The straw book.
You're crazy. But it's a rewarding thing when you've got it done. You say, I've done it. Look at that.
I hear you. Some of my, like, the greatest lessons that I teach my children are at the end of a very frustrating build.
Oh, yeah. You know, if it's easy, there is no reward to it. It's not. It's easy. It's done. You know. Who cares? Yeah. No. We do that. This stuff because it's more difficult.
Yeah.
There is some stuff that I'm always trying to master. Lately, the latest thing that I came up with is to make a reasonable.